press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello students, welcome to the class, and I'm here to teach you the lesson from your detail book, that is a different kind of school. So different kind of school means how the school will be. The school will be where the students come to learn and where they learn several subjects. They listen to the lecture of the teachers, they understand and they learn many things from the teachers. They write the exams, they participate in some sports, they do some functions. Yes, that is the process of the school. But here, the school is something different. How it is different, we'll come to know in this lesson. Okay, so before we go to the lesson, let's have the introduction about the author. The author of the lesson is E.V. Lucas. So E.V. Lucas was a poet, novelist and short story writer. Means he has written many poems, many novels and short stories. Many short stories he has written. And born June 1858. Here the date is not mentioned, only the year is mentioned in UK. And also died in June 1938. So we don't have the particular date of this birth and death, we are having only the year. So E.V. Lucas, he has written the beautiful lesson, that is a different kind of school. So what is a different kind, we'll come to know in the lesson. Before that, I want to tell you, in our society, we see many people suffering from poverty, from any disease, or some poor people, those who are very weak and not able to take care of themselves. Such people we see in the society. What we do for them? If they are poor, we may help them with some money, correct? And if they are suffering from any disease, we can take them to some government hospital. Yes. And if some are weak and there is no one to take care, we can give them some shelter. So many government organizations are there where government take care of these poor and old people. So some or other is there, solution is there. And if you see someone who is physical disability, for example, if the person is blind, okay, how he is leading his life, what are the difficulties he is facing? If we imagine also, we will get tense. See, can you close your eyes and walk for 10 to 15 minutes? Not at all possible. See, for example, if you are not able to speak, okay, you are not able to speak, you are deaf and dumb, then how can you express your feelings? You can write, okay. If you don't know any education also, you don't know to write also, what you will do? Again, it is a big problem. Or just imagine that you don't have a hand. How will you work? You have to be dependent on someone else. If you don't have legs, what you will do? So, such people are there in our society. Those who are physical, they are misfortune. They are not blessed with the good organs and parts of the body. So such people, how their feelings will be? How they lead their life? What are the problems they face? And how can they manage to survive? So this all questions arises in our mind when we see any person who is physically disabled. He is not a normal people. He don't have a hand or leg or eyes, or he is not able to speak, or something or other physical disability he is having. So what are the problems of such people? What are the emotions of such people? That we will come to know in this lesson. And what about different kind of school? What is that? So here, see, in each and every school, students will come, they will study, they will participate in many activities, sports, your annual day or some any other function or some national festivals, something or other. They will be busy in participating this or that, and they will be learning several subjects, and they will writing the exams, and they will write the exams, and they will be promoted for the next level. So this is the process. But here in the different kind of school, in this school only the lessons or subjects are not taught, but they teach something special. What is that special? We'll come to know in this lesson, which is very important for us to learn. Sometimes when we see some disabled people, we don't care them, we even don't go near them. Sometimes we avoid them and we'll move forward. We don't stand and feel their feelings. We don't go forward to help them. That all something sometimes we do, but it's very bad. We have to take care of such disabled people. Okay, so here that moral is taught in this lesson, in this different kind of school, that the teachers and the whole team of that school, they teaches to the students the morality. They teaches the students to be kind, to be helpful, and to understand the problems of disabled. That is very much important, and that is the main motto of the school, to teach the students, that is to understand the feelings and to be kind, and they make them to help the people, how they should help the disabled people. That training is given in this different kind of school. So such special school everybody would like to visit. So here there is one person, his name is not mentioned over here. He is a visitor, and he has heard many lot of things about this different kind of school, that there the teachers teach the morality and being kind and to understand and to help the disabled people. This all training is given there in the school. That the visitor, he heard that and he want to visit that school and want to check how is the training given to the students. What is the different kind of school, that he wants to know by visiting that school. And the owner of the school and the main person of the school is Mrs. Beam. That is the name of that lady who runs the institution. Okay, and she is the president of that school, and she runs the school, and the school name is a different kind of school, and the lady, her name is Miss Beam. Okay, so Miss Beam, she is the person who runs this institution. And here the visitor, once he go and he goes to that place and he visit the school of Miss Beam, and he observed many things over there, and that experience is shared in this lesson. What all he saw in that school, what all the different things he saw in that school, that all experience he has shared in his lesson. So we'll come to know what kind of different school it is. Okay, dear students, keep your textbook open. I will read one paragraph, that is, I had heard, here the I means visitor, okay? I had heard a great deal about Miss Beam's school. So as everybody will speak, you know, there is one school and they are doing like this, and children are learning like this in their school. Everybody will have that knowledge. And this person wants to visit that one. He say, I heard, that is the word told by a visitor. I had heard a great deal about Miss Beam school, but not till last week did the chance come to visit it. So he was very busy and he did not get the chance to go and visit the school, but now he has made his mind, anyhow he is going to visit that school and see that what is going on in that school. When I arrived, so finally he has went to see the school. When, see this I, the word I is denoted, is it is the visitor's word. This is the direct words told by the visitor, okay? When I arrived there, was no one in sight but a girl about 12. her eyes were covered with bandage. So when he entered the school, he saw there is no one, but only one small girl of 12 years. She is there on the ground and her eyes were bandaged. Her eyes were bandaged. And she was being led carefully. So there were one more person, one more small boy. He was helping that girl to walk. Okay? And was being led carefully between the flower beds by a little boy. So she was walking in the garden and that boy was holding her hand and he was helping her to take a walk in the garden. Who was about 4 years younger? Okay, so that boy was 4 years younger. That 12 years girl, she was banded, and this boy, he was 4 years younger, and he was about 9 years, and he was helping that girl to have a walk in the garden. She stopped, and it looked like she asked him who had come. So when visitor was coming, she heard some voice of walking the steps. She heard the sound of steps that someone is coming nearby. So she asked that small boy, who is there coming near to us? He seemed to be describing me to her. So that small boy, he looked back and he told that there is one man coming and taking a round of this ground. Then they passed on. So they went off. Then he went to the chamber in the office of that Miss Beam. Miss Beam was all that I had expected. Means the lady who is running the institution, her name is Miss Beam, and she is old lady. She is one adult lady, old lady, experienced lady. Miss Beam was all that I had expected. And middle age. She was not that much old, middle age. Full of authority, means she was the owner of that institution, she was running the institution and she was taking care of each and every things happening in the school, and she was full of authority. She is the president of the school. Full of authority, yet kindly and understanding. Though she was a owner of the school, she was very kind and very understanding lady. Her hair was beginning to turn grey. Though she was growing old, so her hairs were becoming white and grey. And she had a kind of plump figure that is likely to be comforting to a homesick child. When this visitor entered the office, she was busy convincing a girl, a child, who was homesick. What do you mean by homesick? Homesick means the students, the children who remains at home and did not get apart from the parents. Means some children, they will be staying in the hostel, and when they come out or leave the hostel, don't want. Otherwise, sometimes what you will do, you will go to stay some relative's house for 1 week or 4 days. While going, you will be very happy. You will pack your bags, everything, and you will be happy to go to and stay with your cousins somewhere far. Okay. After reaching there, after 1 or 2 days, you start remembering your parents. Again, you will be calling your parents saying that I am missing you, come and take me, I am missing you, I don't like to stay. So you will be missing your parents. So that condition is called homesick. Means they are not able to stay away from the home. And there was one small child, she was crying, remembering her parents and home. And this Miss Beam, she was convincing that small girl. I asked her some questions. So this visitor, when he entered, he saw that Miss Beam, she is convincing the small child. After he stood there for a few minutes, after that he entered inside and he asked some question to Miss Beam. I asked some questions about her teaching methods. So he asked, so madam, this is your school and what is the process over here? What about the teaching? What about the learning? So this all he started asking the question. Which I had heard were simple. I heard that there is no more lecturing and writing and exams. So is it true? Then how you are teaching the students? When you are not teaching any lessons, when you are not giving any notes, any exams, then in what way you are training the students? He asked the questions. no more than is needed to help them to learn how to do things. Simple spelling, adding, subtracting, multiplying and writing. So the basic things are taught in the school. Miss Beam, she replied to the visitor that yes, we are not much concerned and bothered about the lengthy lessons or the notes or the strict exams or the evaluations. No, we teach only how to lead the life, and we teach only basic things. What is that basic things? That is simple spelling, adding, subtracting, multiplying and writing. So a student should be able to read, write, count, that much. Basic things we teach here, and moreover we teach them how to lead the life. So that was the answer given by the Miss Bain. The rest is done by reading to them by interesting talks. So rest all, we teach the lesson, but how? By telling them the stories, by making them realize something. In such way we teach the lesson, during which they have to sit still and keep their hands quiet. So during the lesson, students are not supposed to open the textbook and keep the finger on it and going like this to the line. No, they should fold their hands, they should sit quiet and only listen what the teacher is teaching. So during which they have to sit still and keep their hands quiet. There are practically no other lessons. So we don't teach that number of lessons. So say some chapters are from 1 to 15 and we have to finish all the chapters. Chapter number 1, chapter number 2. No, not like that. We teach them the important lesson and that they have to listen it by sitting quiet. No writing any notes, no taking any pencil and writing the important points, nothing. They have to only listen. And there are some lessons what we teach by practically making them realize. So some techniques are there by which the students, they train the students. So this was the answer given by the Miss Beam. Then, the real aim of this school is not so much to teach thoughts as to teach thoughtfulness. So the real aim is not only to teach the lesson, something next level to that, that is thoughtfulness, kindness to others. We are not supposed to only give the lesson and after completion of the lesson we will give the notes, and after giving the notes we will tell them the students to by heart, and after by hearting we will give one question paper and you have to write the answer within 40 minutes, not more 1 minute. If you don't give within 40 minutes when the bell rings, we'll snatch the papers. No, we don't do such things. We teach them to be kind. Kindness, the main important aim of the school is to teach kindness to others. That is, the real aim of the school is not to much teach thought as to teach thoughtfulness, kindness to others. We teach them how to be kind to others and being responsible citizen. So what do you mean by responsible citizen? Means before we think of us, we have to think about our society and about our nation. In the welfare and the good work of the others, we have to support for others for doing some good works. We have to think the improvement of our society and our nation. Being a responsible citizen, we should take care of our people and society. So we teach them to be kind and to be responsible citizens. So that is the main aim what is taught in this school. Look out of the window a minute, will you? So Miss Beam, she invited visitor. The visitor was sitting there in front. When he entered the chamber, Miss Beam, she was there in the chamber, and the visitor was sitting opposite to her. Then when explaining, Miss Beam just she just peeped out of the window and she invited the visitor, come here and just look out of the window. I went to the window. Here I means visitor. So when Miss Beam, she invited him, yeah, just come and just look out of the window. He just got up and he went near the window and he just looked out, and what did he see? See here, I went to the window, which overlooked a large garden and a playground at back. So when he saw from the window, there was a big playground and a garden. "What do you see?" Miss Beam asked. "So what are you able to see from the window?" she asked to the visitor. "I see some beautiful grounds," I said. So he said, "I can see some garden playground and some students are playing there," I said, "and lot of jolly children." So there are many children playing in the playground and some children are playing in the garden. "It pains me though to see that they are not so healthy and active looking. So among them there are some children, they are just sitting and watching the other children playing and they are not healthy. They are just sitting and they are enjoying the play of others. I saw, I said, a lot of jolly children, it pains me though to see that they are not so healthy and active looking. When I came in, I saw one poor little girl being led about." So he saw that some children are playing and there are some children who are just watching the other children playing. So he felt bad. Why this small, some children are not playing? They are simply sitting and watching. What happened? He just thought and he came out of the chamber. While coming out, he saw one more girl. "I saw one poor little girl being led about. Now she has some trouble with her eyes." So again one girl, she was banded, her eyes were banded, and one more person was helping her to walk on that veranda. "Now I can see two more girls with the same difficulty." So after going some distance, he saw some more two girls. Their eyes were also banded and they were also helped by some other children to walk on the ground. "And there is a girl with a crutch." See, what do you mean by crutch? Crutches means a cane that provides support under the arm to reduce weight on leg. Means if you are not able to walk, you will have some canes under the arms holding like this and you will lift your leg. So your leg should not get more weight. For that to support you, canes are required. That is called as crutches. Okay? So he said that, "Now I can see a girl with crutches watching the others at play." So that girl, she is on crutches, her legs is banded and she is not able to walk and she is using the crutches to walk there. And she is observing the other children playing and she is smiling for that. She is only observing the other children playing because she is not able to play. Her leg was banded and she was on crutches. "She seems to be hopeless cripple." So while seeing her face, she was watching the other children playing and I can see the nervousness in her eyes. I can see the hopeless emotions on the face, that hopeless cripple. So what mean by cripple? Cripple means a person who has physical disability. Okay, the cripple means a person who has physical disability. That girl is not able to walk and she is not able to run and play. So she is only watching the other children playing and her nervousness, her hopeless, that can be seen in her eyes and her face. "She seems to be a hopeless cripple." Miss Beam laughed. When all these activities when visitors saw, Miss Beam invited the visitor to see out of the window. When he saw out of the window, he saw some garden and playground. Then she told him to come just outside and see and take a round of that. When he went, he saw that some girls are banded with eyes. Their eyes were banded and some other children are helping that girls to walk. And after going some distance, he saw that some children are playing and some children are watching them playing. They are very much weak and they are unhealthy. And after some distance, he saw that there is one girl on crutches and she too is watching the other children playing and she is very much nervous and disappointed because she is not able to walk and play. After listening this, Miss Beam, she laughed loudly. He visitor was shocked. He was seeing everyone activities, that one girl is blind, her eyes were banded, one girl is on crutches. And after seeing that, Miss Wim, she started laughing loudly. Why? Because Miss Beam laughed. Oh no, she said, she is not really lame. The children, what you are seeing, that they are having bandaid on the eyes, the girl on crutches, they are not lame. What do you mean by lame? Lame means unable to walk. The girl who is on crutches, she is not lame. She can walk. Then why she is on crutches? See that? She is not really lame. This is only her lame day. So today's, every day there will be one or other task given to the students. That will be, one will be the blind day. For example, in the class there are 40 member students. Okay? Think that in the class there are 40 members students, and all 10 students are given different tasks. See, from first 10 students, they have to act as a blind. Second 10 students, they have to act like a lame, they're not able to walk. And again, some 10 students, they are deaf and dumb. Some again students are, they are not able to, something or other disability work they will be given. So they have to act whole day, they should play that role. See how beautiful. But here in normal school, what we do? We give only lessons, notes, exam, lesson, notes, exam. But here in a different kind of school, the students are given task to feel the feelings of disability. So Miss Beam says that they are, all are equal, all are healthy and all are fine. Only they are playing their role. And today, that girl, she is playing the role of lame. And one more, the two girls, what you saw, that they are having bandaid on the eyes, they are having blind day today. So they are doing their task and they are good. They are not actually blind or lame. So listening this, the wizard became shocked. How it is possible? She is not really lame. This is only her lame day. The others are not blind too. It is only their blind day. So they are performing their task. They are fine. They don't have any problem, but they are performing their task like that. This is, I must have looked very surprised, for she laughed again. So Miss Wim, she started laughing. So you felt very bad that they are not able to walk, or that girls are not able to see. But actually it is not like that. They are perfect. Only they are playing their task. This is a very important part of our system. So this is the actual training what we give. To make our children, this is very important part of our system. So what we do in the school is this. We train them to be kind. How we can train them to be kind? First, we should make them realize the pain. Then only you will come to know how to be kind. See, we can say that, oh, that person is not able to walk, so poor. We can just imagine. If we are in such situation, then we will come to know what is the difficulty. So Miss Beam wants the children to feel the feelings of disability. Then they will learn how to help the others. So she said that this is very important part of our system. To make our children appreciate and understand misfortune. So Miss, being a misfortune is not a, we should not say that they are neglected people. They are also gifted. They are also created by God. We should not depress them. We should not degrade them, saying that you are not able, you are having physical, you are handicapped. Should not disappoint them. You should give them strength. You should motivate them. You should help them. That quality should come in you only when you realize the feelings of that disabled people. So she say that we make our children appreciate and understand misfortune. You should understand first. You should realize first. We make them share in misfortune too. So only we give them tasks so that they can understand the difficulty. They should feel the feelings, they should feel the pain of that disabled people. So only we make them share in misfortune too. Each term, every child has a blind day. So each term, say from the for 3 months or 6 months, one term. So each term, all students, they have to act as a blind. So each term, every child has a blind day, one lame day, one deaf day, one injured day, and one dumb day. See, there are the four tasks. One is blind day. So during the blind day, they have to put the bandage on their eyes, and whole day they should act as if they are blind. And second is lame. They are not able to walk. They should be on crutches. And one is deaf. They are not able to hear, and deaf and dumb. They are not able to speak and they are not able to hear. And one is injured. Injured means they are having injured hands and legs, and they are not able to do their work by their own. And one is dumb. We are not able to speak also. So these tasks are given. See, if I tell you to put the bandage on your eyes and be for one day, is it possible? It's not possible. We can't. And if I tell you, you just act as if you are dumb. You are not able to speak. Whole day, how you will express your feelings? How you will tell that you are hungry? How you will tell that you want this and that? Or if I tell you think that you are not able to hear anything, then how you will stay without listening any noise? Or if I tell you that you act as a lame, means you are not able to walk, you are on crutches, and you have to lift the crutches and walk very difficultly. You can't run, you can't walk, you can't play. So it's difficult. Then one lame day, one deaf day, one injured day, and one dumb day. During the blind day, their eyes are bandaged absolutely, and they are honored not to peep. So students also so obediently they will follow that when their eyes are blinded, they will not peep from down also. That much tightly they will put the bandage. The bandage is put on overnight so that wake blind. See, when they will tie the bandage, night. So when they sleep, if the morning it is a blind day, the students has to tie the bandage at night, and morning when they get up, they are not able to see anything. So like that only they have to get up, they have to go for washroom, they have to dress themselves, they have to eat everything, they have to listen everything, the lesson, they have to take the work, whole day they have to do like that, and that bandage will open only in the next night. Then the bandage will put on overnight so that they wake up blind. This means they need help with everything. So morning when they wake up, they want help for some other person to help them for each and everything. To go for washroom, to wear the dress, whether the dress is right or no, it is a proper way or no. Then to eat, to dress, to comb, and for each and everything they should be dependent on others. For that purpose, what they do? This means they need help for everything. Other children are given duty of helping them and leading them about. Suppose if I am acting as a blind, one person is given for me to help. So that person will guide me, that keep the step here. After two steps, there is one thing. You just come, turn to the right, turn to the left. That all guiding. One person will be as a guiding. So like that. See how beautiful training it is given there. That means they need help for everything, and other children are given duty of helping them and leading them. Those who are blind, so one person is given them as a helping hand so that they can guide them each and everywhere. They are learned so much in this way, both blind and helpers. So both the partners, they learn. See, if I am blind, I will come to know what's the difficulty. And the helper, he will come to know how, in what way he has to help the blind. So both are trained, the blind and the helper. See how beautiful. There is no misery about it, Mr. Bhim continued. So acting like this and playing the task like this, that blind day, dumb day, deaf day, there is nothing problem in that. Everyone is very kind. So all people, all the students in this institution, they are helping and acting very well. And it is really something of a game. They play it as a game. Before the day is over, though, even the most thoughtless child realizes what misfortune is. When the task is complete from morning to evening, they will share their experience. So if being a blind, what were the difficulties the whole day he faced? What were the difficulties he will express? If the dumb, if the person is given the task of dumb or deaf or injured, they will express their pain. So being a deaf, it was like this. Being a lame, it was like this. It was very difficult. So that all they will express, and they will realize the pain of the disabled. Even the helpers, they will come to know in what way we have to help such people. So evening, they will share their experience of the day. In such beautiful way, the training is given in the school. See how beautiful. Even we can't stop, we can't shut our mouth for more than 10 to 15 minutes. But whole day, if you have to stay as a deaf and dumb, how you will? If permanently, if any person is disabled, he is not able to speak, how he can lead his life? That feelings, that pain will come to know only when we realize that things. Then we'll come to know in what way we have to help them. This is the best training given in this different kind of school. Like this, many training they give. Here it is there, and that we'll come to know in the second part of the lesson. So dear students, you just go through with the lesson, read the whole lesson, underline the difficult words, okay? And if you find any problem, any difficulty, you can drop the message. Underline the difficult words, and some meanings are given here in the textbook, and some I have written here on the board, you can copy down. Even about the poet author also I have written, you can copy down. And you can realize and you can imagine if the person is deaf or dumb or blind or lame or injured, how the situation will be, how they have to take care of themselves, how they are dependent on others. If someone is there to help, okay. If there is no one to help, how they will survive, how they survive their life. That all imagination you can do, and we'll see in the next class what is the other training given in this different kind of school, in what way children are trained to be a good citizen and to be kind. So it's really a beautiful lesson, different kind of school. So dear students, hope you understood this first part. So here I have completed up to paragraph 10, okay? So tomorrow we will start from paragraph 11, okay? In the next class, we will start from paragraph 11, and you can read the lesson up to paragraph 10. Read the whole lesson, try to imagine the story and the problems of disabled, and if you find any doubts, any difficulties, you can drop the message, we'll clarify your doubts. Okay, dear students, hope you understood the first part of this lesson. Read the whole lesson, and we'll meet in the next class with the second part of this lesson. Till then, take care, thank you, bye-bye.